Hello there, this is TK55550 for FIST Empire News. First up, we have a message from our detachment leader, TK11469.
Hello everyone out there watching our Order 66 charity fundraiser event. I'm Andrew Frank, TK11469, detachment leader of the 1st Imperial Stormtrooper Detachment, FIST. Today we're going to invite you into our small part of the world and hopefully enlighten you on the who we are and what we do as far as costuming is concerned for the 501st. So let's start with the basics. We look after arguably the most iconic character costumes of the Star Wars universe, the First Order and Imperial Stormtroopers, or as we call them, TKs. For many, these costumes are a childhood dream, and making those dreams a reality is our specialty as we provide the most extensive resource available in the galaxy. Founded in 2006, FIST is the largest costuming detachment of the 501st, with over 5,500 members globally. Considering Stormtroopers are the general ground troops of the Empire and the First Order, you can imagine why we have such numbers in our ranks. I hope you enjoy our presentation of the most popular costume to blast its way onto the big screen in 1977's Star Wars A New Hope, the Imperial TK.
Thank you, TK11469, for your introduction and the insights to our statistics. Now let's have a closer look to the ANH stunt, the A New Hope stunt armor, the most common costume in the Legion.
The 501st Legion has hundreds of CRLs, or costume reference libraries, and amongst these you'll find a list of the costumes looked after by us, the 1st Imperial Stormtrooper Detachment. As mentioned before, the most common Stormtrooper costume is the ANH stunt armour from Episode 4, A New Hope. So today we're going to take you through that particular costume. Each CRL is a combination of images and descriptions providing the costumer with a comprehensive guide to assembling their armour to 501st standard for basic approval. CRLs start with a complete image of the costume at the top, followed with the detailed description written in black underneath. Expert Infantry and Centurion can be found highlighted in blue and red in text on the CRLs. At FISD, we created two higher levels of accuracy, giving our members the opportunity to go above and beyond the basic approval standards. Expert Infantry and Centurion level 2 and 3 were created for those wishing to push the envelope even closer to screen accuracy and take their costume and its finer details even closer to movie realism. These two higher level programs are entirely optional and don't form part of the basic 501st approval process. They are simply created and driven by the detachment in the pursuit of costuming excellence. The helmet is undoubtedly the favourite piece for many, and it's interesting to note that the assembly of this is exactly the same as it was back in the movie production phase. The faceplate is where most of the action occurs with detail. These helmets were hand-painted, but nowadays the option exists with stencils available for those who may not have a steady hand. The eyes require a flat green in colour lens with plenty of material options available, but the most common is a green acetate material. The frown is in reference to what looks like a mouth on the helmet, and this area is painted in grey and remains within the teeth area. As we move further down the face, we come to what is known as the tube stripes. These are the blue lines you can see either side on the cheeks. Other standout features are the vocoder, central on the chin, and the aerators or hovey tips to either side. As we are focusing on areas of detail today, next we shall move on to the abdomen section called the ab plate. You'll notice that there are some control panel-like buttons on this piece, and the buttons are painted the same blue and grey colours used on the helmet. Around the abdomen is the belt. Now the belt is of composite construction, consisting of several pieces and materials. A plastic face or piece called the ammo belt, a soft belt proper made of a canvas-like material, and drop boxes that hang from the proper via elastic straps. As we turn the TK around and look at its back, we see a piece that hooks over the belt. This part is called the thermal detonator and is also constructed from multiple materials. The main cylinder, a white control panel, and attachment clips generally made of metal or aluminium. The cylinder is also painted in the same grey colour as some of the helmet and ab button pieces. Other details of note on the ANH stunt TK.
are the small MO belt that wraps around the bottom ridge at the front of the right thigh, and the sniper plate, which affixes to the top ridge of the left greave or shin. We hope you enjoyed this brief introduction into our most popular CRL. You can take an in-depth look either in the FISD forums under the Pages tab beneath our banner or on the 501st Legion website.
For everyone curious about how to build their own helmets, TK42911 has a special video. Please enjoy.
Hi everyone, it's Dan here. Just wanted to run through my HDPE lid from DA Props. As you can see, fully complete now, but as per some of the pictures I'll put up now, this started off in the sort of green khaki coloured HDPE plastic. It's then been fully built and sprayed to match the originals as much as possible. So in terms of build, things like matching the ears to the line of the rear trap, trying to make sure they follow right the way through. That's apparent on both sides. Things like the eye construction you'll see there, if I get that there. The eyes haven't been smoothed out too much with the Dremel, for example. They've been cut with a sharp knife to give that original A&H style look. From the side there, you'll see that the alignment of the faceplate is roughly that this line across the back runs just above the eyes. So you do then get that nice sort of authentic looking, again, the A&H style. That does mean as well that this swoop at the back from the cap, the rear, runs across and down. So it's just a nice alignment of the helmet from there. Down to the painting. All of this was resprayed with oxide red. So that's the base coat oxide red. Then white primer, and then the ears are applied, and then you go over the top of that with the gloss white. In this case, for a slightly off-white look, it's Halfords Diamond White to give it the off-white appearance. The tube stripes as well are actually a slightly different shade of blue, again to be more authentic to the originals, make it look a bit more aged, not quite as vibrant as the regular blue. In terms of hobby tips, as the originals were, they're white on the inside and then obviously black on the outside. The fronts are slightly white as well, which again is quite matched to the originals. And then the vocoder paint, I've got a bit of information about most of this on Stormtrooper Armoury, and the second and sixth bars on the original vocoders, the majority of them were quite high, so you do get this sort of high level here. So that, as I say, is my HDPE DA Props helmet, fully resprayed to closely match the originals as much as possible. This is my only one I've got so far, but there will be more projects coming up with these. That's it for now. Thank you very much. See you all soon.
Thank you, TK42911, for your hard work. If this build video has sparked your interest, you should definitely check out the Home of the 1st Imperial Stormtrooper Detachment, short FISD. You can find it on www.whitearmor.net, and it contains the biggest library the internet has ever seen regarding anything Stormtrooper armor.
The best place for newcomers to start their journey is our Getting Started section on the FISD forums. Here you'll find loads of great information to get you well underway, like supply lists, vetted armour makers, and much, much more. So who are the Imperial Attachés? Not only are they a great source of knowledge on our forums, but they also assist new members at their local garrison level. Have a question? These guys and gals are here to help. On the FISD forums, we also have a TK pre-approval section. Here, future troopers have the opportunity to submit photos of their completed build to be reviewed before they take them to their garrison command staff for final approval. Our advanced tactics section of the forums is dedicated to our higher levels of costume approval. Expert infantry is a minor step up from basic to get you looking closer to the seen on screen stormtroopers, designed as a relatively easy advancement for any member to achieve. Centurion is our top echelon. This level is more demanding and requires greater attention to detail. We focus on the very fine elements of your armour as well as fit and alignment with a more critical eye. FISD is currently on a mission called March to 1000. The detachment goal is to reach 1000 members approved at the level 2 expert infantry. We're getting closer day by day with only 33 more approvals needed to hit that milestone. Will it be you? The First Order Stormtroopers are also a very important part of our detachment and Star Wars history. Please come and take a look at the latest addition to our forums, the First Order Battle Group, rich with details, guides and advice. You can also make your First Order dreams a reality. For help outside of the forums, we can also be found on social media platforms, Facebook, Twitter and Instagram.
And now to TK50893 for the weather.
Thank you, TK55550. Now let's have a look at the weather forecast for the lovely planet of Alderaan. Tomorrow will be very sunny in the morning, followed by some clouds in the afternoon. On Tuesday, there will be no weather at all, but I'm authorized to tell you the details.
Empire News with the FISD's contribution to the Order 66 fundraiser event. This is TK55550 signing off.